previously on Arrow.
So my brother's a ghost.
10 years ago, I found out you were dealing.
Yeah. You convinced me to enlist.
I saw what kind of man my brother was, what kind of man he is.
He's your family. You said he was a good man. Maybe perhaps to enlist.
The damage to her spinal cord, it's permanent. She's never gonna walk again.
If we don't get home soon, the sitter's gonna charge us an extra hour. We should have taken the car.
So does what? Another $15 for half an hour? It's a bargain at twice the price. Lila.
Dear God.
Alan.
Sorry to crash your evening.
Then don't. Just call like normal people.
I don't have a normal job. And I've been compromised.
I'm not Argus anymore.
Which makes you the only person I can trust. I need you to tell Walter.
Careful.
Do you want me to be careful?
Oh, this is more Oliver 2.0, isn't it? Do you think being cute is going to distract me?
Mission accomplished.
You don't have to wait on me hand and foot. No, I wouldn't say no to a blanket.
Doctor says stick with the 2 tablets. Keep with your current pain management regimen.
You know, I really appreciate what you're doing, but you have a city to save. In your old campaign, a freaky super badge who can move things with his mind.
None of which are nearly as important as your recovery.
I think the people in the city that Dark wants to destroy might disagree.
Well, those people should know that I stand no chance of stopping Baby in Dark without your help.
Well, you might have to. I have a spinal cord injury. I might never make a full recovery. Ever.
That is worst case scenario. And either way, you are still a vital member of the team. Your superpower. It's right there.
Maybe my new codename could be Hot Wheels.
Keep pitching on that.
All jokes aside, like you said, what I do bring to the team is my mind, and there's a lot on it.
So talk to me.
I just don't think I'm ready to come back yet. And the last thing you need in a life or limb situation is me.
Wow, we are going to agree to disagree on that one for the moment.
What's going on?
John and Lila were attacked.
Oh my God, are they okay?
John was shot, flesh wound. I should go see them. We should go see them.
Nice try.
Dinner is in the fridge. Reheat the oven at 425 degrees.
I love you. And they just left you there?
Yeah, not before leaving me with this.
We are sure that this was a hive.
These men looked military.
Right, but you said that Chang said he was compromised, and he specifically told you to go and speak with Waller.
Knowing her, she had Alan working on something off the books. I need to call the sitter.
Okay.
We need to find Chang before this kidnapping becomes something worse.
Yeah, well, the van didn't have any place on him. And Chang's phone is Argus issued, which means it'll be untraceable.
He could really use Felicity's help right now.
Yeah, she's not up for it yet.
I can have SCPD see if John's bullet is connected to any open cases.
Yeah.
I can go check the crime scene for any leftover evidence.
You should go to Starling General and have that looked at.
I'll be fine.
Why? Because eating a cheeseburger was a better option?
This isn't for me. It's for Andy.
Hey, why did your arm?
Nothing, it's occupational hazard.
Man, I never pegged you for the mass vigilante type.
Yeah, well, I guess we're both full of surprises, Andy.
You know what? You keep coming down here asking all these questions, but I never get to ask them back.
Well, no.
How do you end up working out of a basement or wherever we are and fighting crime with a guy who wears a green hoodie?
Well, he's a good man, and we're not fighting crime, Andy.
We're taking a city that's holding itself together, and we are helping.
Don't you remember when that was your mission?
Appreciate you two volunteering for this mission.
Chance to ride with my little brother? Wouldn't miss it.
Yeah, Taliban's not ready for the Dickel brothers.
HQ's got eyes on a primo opium shipment that's been funding the local arms trade. We cut them off, the Terriers will be left with nothing but rocks and sticks to fight us.
Copy that, sir. You ready for this?
Stay frosty, boys!
Right
there.
Underneath!
Why didn't I get invited to this pity party?
Hello?
At least you found the right party favors.
Three pills is a bit much, but who am I to judge?
Okay, whoever you are, you picked the wrong woman on the wrong night to mess with.
Lee, we both know you're in no position to do anything. If you did, you'd be back out in the world and settled up here.
What's going on? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I'm losing it. I am completely and utterly losing it. Ah! Now I'm talking to myself. Not exactly.
Lawyer Lance, District Attorney's Office. What do we have here?
Deceased male, around 35, Asian. Multiple lacerations, contusions, and blunt force trauma.
You canvass the area yet? We could be witnesses or something.
I don't need an ADA to tell me how to do my job.
Well, I'm sure there's a murderer out there who appreciates your lack of initiative. Go ahead. Security found him at the start of graveyard shift.
Last check. Whoever did this took their time. Multiple lacerations to the knees, a broken arm, at least three pulled fingernails.
They were torturing him for something.
Information was in the audio they wanted.
I told you, what Agent Chang was working on is none of your concern. It's even less of yours.
Well, no change once you found out that Chang was mutilated, tortured, and killed.
I'm afraid you've overextended your welcome, Mr. Diggle.
Which is hard to speak for, get the hell out of here.
You always were a quick study. I mean this with all sincerity. Your presence has truly been missed. Even if I don't show it, I am deeply regretful for Mr. Chang's death. Hopefully we'll meet again under happier circumstances. Of course.
Heat, increased appetite, risk infection. Oh, good. Hallucination. I really thought I was smarter than this.
You are not me, and you're definitely not real.
I used to be you. Or you used to be me. Strong, confident, brunette.
You wasted all that away to go play superhero. And look where that got you.
Okay, so wait, this Waller person said that she couldn't tell you anything and then gave you that flash drive?
Argus has 24/7 internal surveillance. She didn't want anyone to know she was giving me what she was giving me.
The question is, what did she give you?
I've seen that symbol before.
It's a logo, actually. Shadowspire is a U.S. Army Special Forces unit. Argus took them down 3 years ago when they were exposed as war profiteers in an op-run by Alan Chang.
And what about those other two guys?
They've been reported missing for 2 days.
If those were the missing agents that were part of Shadowspire,
then the rest of Shadowspire is going to be on a payback mission.
We need to find the other two agents before they end up like Alan.
Hey, I think I found something. That logo, that was on the flash drive that Waller gave you.
Shadowspire.
I thought I recognized that from someplace. I ran into a lot of those guys back in the stand. I need to talk to my brother again.
You would think the reward for confiscating an opium shipment would be additional duty guarding it.
Would you respect a kiss from the president?
I'm my two conquering heroes.
Wet and tired.
We are good, sir.
You gentlemen did good today.
Thank you, sir.
You ever think about your future beyond working in this hellhole?
I don't know. Personal security, bodyguarding, maybe?
You boys are meant for better things. Three of us could make bank if a few bricks of that sweet Afghani powder happened to go AWOL before the morning.
You know I'm going to have to decline, sir. My mama taught me never to trust dirty war profiteers.
You should probably watch your tone. You might end up in worse shape with those tallies yesterday. As you were.
Well, look at you.
What you talking about?
Back in Sterling, you would have jumped at any opportunity to earn a little extra scratch. The place has been good for you. Proud of you, Andy.
So exactly how many evil organizations are you associated with? I'm beginning to lose count.
What are you talking about?
Shadowspire. Your old army buddies are in Starling City. They tortured and killed an Argus agent and abducted two others.
I have nothing to do with them anymore. After I get discharged, they cut ties. They only want enlisted men.
How the hell could I not see this? You were with me the entire time.
Because you saw what you wanted to see. Look, you wanted to believe that the army had straightened me out. Look, I'm your brother. But I'm not built like you. I didn't take to the military like you did. You saw the world as something to be fixed. I only saw it as broken. So I made sure I had enough to survive in it.
So you pretended to be a completely different person around your own brother.
Spare me the look that's on your face right now. But maybe some good could come out of this.
Andy, talking about?
Two missing agents. You said that they're alive?
I can hope.
And I can help. Look, I know how Shadowspire operates. If they're consistent, they'll use the nearest free port as a base of operations. The best place to hide illicit things is right next to legitimate ones.
It's called a freeport. Most commodities are either in transit between international destinations pretty low.
Like somebody upgraded their security system.
Motion sensors, these trip wires, these locks.
I think I know somebody who can help. Can I get that? Oliver?
I'm on the field, actually. We've come up against some tactics of the kind that you typically eat for breakfast now. I know that you said you're not ready to get back in the saddle, but we can really use your help.
You're not really falling for that again, are you? Where are you?
Pacific Forward, it's a series zone. That feels amazing. All you need to do is get back in the game.
The vomiting in my mouth is just like fresh.
I'm inside their security system. I got eyes on seven very menacing-looking fellows guarding a bunch of holding containers. Infrared in one of the containers. I'm working on opening that lock.
Go for the hostages and take care of Shadowspire.
Containers open. Should be 10 feet in front of you. Second container on your right.
Got it.
We found the two Argus.
They're both dead.
Get out of here, then.
What about you and Spartan?
We got this. Go! What's going on?
I don't know. I must have tripped some sort of failsafe. The system's overloaded with too many requests.
About these vigilantes.
But I've never seen one in person. We have to sit stand by a cold-blooded murderer.
Have we met before?
Okay, let's go. I've got Spartan. We're good.
No thanks to you.
Is that I can no longer be a part of the team.
Because of your injury? You can't let that stop me.
Except it has. Look at me, Oliver. I spent the last week and a half stuck in this loft. I can't move. I can't drive. I can't walk down the street and get a cup of coffee. And if tonight is any indication, I can't do the one thing that I'm supposed to still be able to do.
You just need to give it time. Hey, talk to me.
Go ahead. Tell him. Tell him you're hallucinating. That should go over like gangbusters.
I'm not going to pretend that I understand.
Don't hallucinate. Tell him.
What you're going through. But you are the strongest person
that I know. You're no good for the team.
That
inefficient having legs.
We have your back the same way that you have our back. You don't stand a chance to take that apart last night.
Shut up! I didn't mean that.
I didn't mean to upset you.
No, no, it's not you. It's not you. Can I just be alone for a little while?
I guess I hope by giving you intel on Shadowspire, you would let me out of my cell. But this isn't what I had in mind. Hey, Lila, it's been a while.
Andy?
Mr. Diggle, I'm the director of Argus. Those three dead men were my agents. I want to debrief you on your relationship to Shadowspire.
Which is interesting because you couldn't even say Shadowspire last time we met.
I was taking an understandable precaution in light of a potential security breach. The two agents you found tonight were assigned to safeguard a shipment of confiscated railguns. That was a completely black assignment. So I'd be very interested to know how Shadowspire knew about it.
Amanda, you don't see the bigger problem here? Those things fire off electromagnetic projectiles. Just one of them could take down a building.
Your point?
My point is that if Shadowspire is looking for that type of ordinance...
I'm far more concerned with the catastrophic security breach in my organization, Mr. Diggle.
It doesn't matter. Shadowspire's not after railguns. And what if you're wrong, Andy?
I thought you weren't hooked up with Shadowspire anymore.
I'm not. But I know the way they work. Shadowspire's all about misdirection. An elite military unit. A cover for a criminal organization. A heist of a shipment of railguns. No. Distraction. They're after something else.
You want to talk about it?
What is there to talk about? Felicity's upset. I don't know how to help her. It seems entirely straightforward.
As the only other person here who's had the privilege of dating you, a piece of advice.
Okay.
Don't be so hard on yourself.
Everything that's happening is my fault.
I knew you were going to say that.
Last month, when we went up against Vandal Savage, Barry traveled through time and changed things.
What?
Barry can travel through time. And he warned me that when you change the past fights back. So for the past month, I have been tortured by the idea that what happened to Felicity might have happened because I wouldn't listen to him.
The only person who's responsible for what happened to Felicity is Damien Dark.
John, we're on it. John thinks Shadowspire's going after a shipment of railguns. Can you go see it?
Felicity, she makes her own choice with you. I'm sure that's one of the reasons why you love her so much.
Wow. Shiny. Not sure if I should be flattered or insulted.
Oh, my God, Dad, just go away already.
If I'm you, it can be a little difficult, I think.
Fine. I'm here. You're here. So why are we here? Do you have anything the least bit interesting to say to me besides the little jabs you keep making?
Jabs are just to get your attention.
So what do you want to tell me?
I'm not here to tell you anything. I'm here to show you.
The last time we looked like this, Cooper had just fake died.
What does this have to do with my ex-boyfriend?
The day we thought he died,
you broke out the hair dye, ditched the contacts, and decided
you weren't going to rely on anyone else for help ever again. It was just going to be you against the world, and that was going to be your armor.
Guess I should have chosen Kevlar.
Stop it.
Stop feeling sorry for yourself, and stop pretending.
Pretending?
Pretending that this is the real you.
The blonde hair, glasses, sensible fashion. People wear masks for a reason, to hide who they are, just like you have been doing for the past 5 years.
First you decided to sign up for being the world's most overqualified IT girl, and then you decide to try being a hero.
Look what it got you.
It rings side seat to the rest of your life.
You thought you were such a badass.
So Waller says the shipment of railguns is in the back of that truck, moving out in less than an hour.
What does Shadowspire want with a whole shipment of railguns? Absolutely nothing good. It's nice to have you back, Agent Michaels. Feels like old times.
It feels like old times as you keeping secrets that get good people killed. Did it ever occur to you that Alan and the other two agents might still be alive if you hadn't tried to keep your anti-Shadowspire operations off the books?
Of course it has. The ugly side of our business is that sometimes security has to be paid for in blood.
Thank you. I was wondering why I'd left.
I don't know what you're worried about, man. The team's not seeing action tonight. Yeah, and I'm not with them because I'm here babysitting you.
Where are they?
Something's wrong.
There's no movement on the railgun ship.
Distraction. Argus is the If this is retribution for the work Agent Chang and I did crippling Shadow Spire, clearly it didn't take.
Vengeance and retribution are useless pursuits. For one thing, they don't pay. I'm here for Rubicon. And you're going to give me the codes to access it.
You know I can't do that.
I do. That's why I kept all these people alive. I'm going to give you 20 minutes. And then... I'm going to ask you again.
Damn it. Must have cameras in here. No cell or Wi-Fi service. Would you like to share with the rest of the class?
These monitors work just like TVs. Receiving broadcast signals on a 700 megahertz band. I have a friend who's into this kind of stuff. Occasionally I listen to her. If I could just switch the chipset into transmitting mode, I should be able to contact my team.
Oh, man, Lila does not have time to work with her team. We've got to do something.
Yeah, well, you're not doing anything, Andy.
Oh, man, your wife is in there. Now's not the time to not trust me.
Blackjack. I was telling him about the car counter ticket you talked.
Really, Andy?
Yeah, really.
Okay, man. Because I can't have you backsliding, all right?
Man, I agreed to go through this whole army thing. And I kept my letter mark. Now I need you to keep yours. And I need you to start treating me like a brother and not like a criminal. Okay? I'm sorry.
Shadowspire never made a move on the shipment, so whatever their next move is, it's not rail guns. Just call me when you get something new from your brother.
All right. Oh, I am so glad our new lair has elevator access.
Hi.
Curtis has anointed himself my personal chauffeur. Fancy. It's a good thing he didn't ask too many questions about coming to your campaign office in the middle of the night.
What are you doing here?
Well, I was at home. Feeling more self-pity than I have in my entire life when it hit me. This is who I am. I wanted to come along on an awesome superhero adventure because I wanted to help people. And the old me was so angry at the world that anger never accomplished anything. It just created more anger and some seriously bad personal style choices. I wanted to do some good in the world. That was a good speech. I thought you'd be a little more impressed.
It was a good speech, but...
But how did it go again? I know you, and I do. You're probably thinking what happened was your fault. I'm here to tell you that it's not, and that it's not mine either. It's the fault of only one man, and he's extremely on the nose and obliterated me. And we're going to stop him. Not out of guilt or vengeance or regret. We are going to stop him because it's what we do. It's who we are.
It was a good speech. Yeah. I'm very happy to hear it.
You're going to need to get some ramps.
Argus has been compromised. And Lila's being held hostage.
Alice in your office. Hope you don't mind.
Lieutenant, we picked up an unauthorized comm out of the detention area.
Take someone and look into it.
Yes, sir.
Go on. You might not get the chance to enjoy it again. It's been 20 minutes. I'm going to have to downsize your organization yet again.
Apparently.
Man, that's rather cold-blooded.
You really don't know her that well at all, do you? So Michaels is one of my most trusted agents. She knows better than anyone that I'm perfectly capable of watching you execute every person in this room. And I'll still never give you the Rubicon access codes.
Is that right, Miss Michaels?
It's right. That's why I left. Amanda Waller doesn't make decisions based on the value of human life.
Penny.
No!
Well, Miss Michaels, most trusted agent. Looks like you now have 20 minutes.
Maybe.
Well, I thought that it was time you got a code name. What do you think?
Perfect.
Let's go with all the moments taken.
Shadowspire's got the entire area around TNC in lockdown.
You guys are the only game in town.
Can you get us inside? What's that? I mean...
Well, it's about time you guys came looking.
Who the hell are you supposed to be?
Sergeant Andrew Diggle, 52nd Regiment, 5th Battalion.
What are you doing locked up here?
It's a long story. Short version being, my brother's a jerk.
Lucky for me, though, your CO and I go in. If you're serious about Lila Michaels giving up the Rubicon codes, we'll get on the radio and tell Lieutenant Joyner, the guy that taught him how to count cards, is here. And, what's up?
Here, I thought I put on weight.
What are you doing at Argus? Much less alive.
Amanda Waller brought me in because of my former association with you guys. But, small world, though. Your friend, Ms. Michaels? She's my sister-in-law.
Andy?
Point being, her husband is crawling around these ventilation shafts right now. If you put a gun on her, she'll tell you whatever you need to know.
Son of a...
Turning on your own brother, that's high school.
Now, you know better than most. John and I never saw eye to eye.
Gentlemen, check the facility's ventilation shafts. Oh, watch.
CNC, 3 floors down, northeast corner.
Now give us a few minutes.
Isn't this quaint?
I get out of these coasts and you see how quaint these can be.
It's a shame you can't be more like the little Diggle.
His pragmatism has proven to be quite the asset.
Now, if your brother's right, you should be able to convince your wife to give me what I want.
Tony, if Rubicon ever got out in the open...
Miss Michaels, in 5 seconds, it's your husband's brains that will be out in the open. 4, 3, 2...
You've run out of guys to punch. Spartan needs an assist. 2 assists, actually.
Tell us what to do.
Shadowspire is getting the access codes for a secure vault in the sublevel. I'm trying to stop the codes from working, but I'm going to need Canary and Speedy if my insurance policy.
What do you want me? This is taking too long.
Something's wrong. Someone's locking me out of the system.
Thank you.
Wanted to see me, sir. Already got my cut.
That's a token of appreciation from the boss. Traded the opium for something else.
Like what?
Ask him yourself.
Thank you for your assistance, Mr. Dingle. Lieutenant Joyner sings your praises.
Happy to help. What did you get for the opium?
Legend speaks of a place of immeasurable power. Many have disappeared searching for it. So much so that the locals simply refer to it by one word. Purgatory.
Thought we were totally unpacked.
Just humor me.
What am I getting?
Yes, the white box. Yeah. Really?
Wow! When you said that you made some bad personal style choices, you weren't kidding.
This is the old me. A rebellious brunette hacker. Didn't listen to anyone else's rules but her own.
You're not that person anymore?
Nope.
What you did last night was amazing.
I was really badass. Yeah. Though the old me probably would have stolen the plans for Rubicon and released them some sort of political statement.
The old me would have snapped Joyner's neck.
Yeah.
We've both grown.
Thank you for always being on my side.
No place I'd rather be.
Hand me that garbage can. And lighter.
How much medication do you want?
Absolutely none. I just want to make sure that my past stays the past, you know?
One more thing for me. The doctor said your condition is permanent. And I don't think that it's healthy or productive for either of us to live in denial. But I've seen people speed and shrink and fly. We watched a friend of ours come back from the dead. That is the world that we live in now. And I will not stop searching it until we find a way to make you walk again.
Hey, are you sure about this?
Because I'm not.
Better than being in that cage, right? Then we'll wait outside. I have it from here. Make yourself comfortable. Right, let's cut this up.
Hey, this is about reconnecting with Carly and Andy as well, and I get it. Step by step, right?
Andy?
Hey.
I'm making pork roast. Donnie said it's your favorite.
Yeah, it is. I got another surprise for you, man. Just a second. Hey, Lila,
Not a word. John and I both agreed to this. She's excited to meet you.
This is your niece.
Hey.
Sarah, that's your Uncle Andy.
Hey.
Yeah. She's got Mom's eyes. Welcome home, man.
Move your head.